Hi, everybody. I'm Anastasia Anagnostakos, National Business Development Manager here at ASX Investment Products. And today we have a very special webinar with multi-award-winning fund manager Hyperion. Hyperion are leaders in active portfolio management, and in particular, their Global Growth Fund is the top-performing fund in the Morningstar Equity World Large Growth category over a five-year period ending 30 June last year. So with their upcoming launch of their Global Growth Fund to the ASX under ticker HYGG, we have with us today Chairman of Hyperion, Tim Samway, to take us through some of the portfolio's top stock ideas. Tim, welcome to this ASX webinar.
Thank you very much. Lovely to be here.
Great. Well, why don't we just kick off with your first idea?
Indeed, I'd love to do that. And before I start, I should make it clear that these aren't securities recommendations. Please get your own advice, but they are companies that we hold in our portfolio at present. So the first one I'm going to talk about is PayPal. It's had a terrific year. In fact, both of the companies I'm going to talk about today have had a terrific year. The pandemic has been really good for them in that PayPal, particularly what happened, people stopped using cash and they started using digital payments much more regularly. Obviously, they didn't want to handle that dirty cash. And this is a business, we've owned it for a while now, but it's managed to accumulate 377 million users and 29 million merchants in less than 10 years. It's just an outstanding performance. And they're not stopping that. They're not stopping at that. They're effectively becoming the super app for financial services. So they're introducing, you can buy cryptocurrencies. I know a lot of people might think that's a little esoteric, but the others in the game are also doing this. And crypto is becoming a very important trading opportunity. They put a reward system in, you'll be able to buy deposits, put deposits down by other financial services like equities. So this is a terrific growth story. It's growing at better than 20% per annum, and we think it'll continue to do that for the next 5 to 10 years. It's always the long term we're thinking about there. So it's a very exciting opportunity. We've seen a lot of competitors in that area, and these digital payment businesses are really coming to the fore. The second stock I'd like to talk about today is Spotify. Some of you will have heard of that. Clearly, it's a streaming music app. That's a business that's also come from nowhere very quickly. What's the good news is that the previous shareholders have effectively absorbed all the losses of getting to scale. That business now has about 345 million users in 175 countries. And it's growing very quickly. Compare that with Apple, with the last time they reported at 72 million users. They're clearly winning the race to the top. And it's a scale game because it's a data game. That is, if you own more data, you can stream the right music. You can help users find the music that they want. I mean, there's a lot of music being added every day, 60,000 new tracks every day. That's a ridiculous amount of music being added. But the way that their algorithm works is it enables you to get through to the music you like very quickly. And you know, we've found that those businesses like this, particularly in radio, what they're doing is that they're disrupting the radio business. So radio has been very sticky for many years in terms of advertising. But with the introduction of podcasts, businesses like Spotify are really grabbing lots of users who would otherwise listen to the radio. And the addressable market, the size of that market is massive. I mean, it's sort of a $200 billion market share. And at the moment, Spotify really, its revenue this year is expected to be about 9 billion euros. So there's a long way to go. So both of these stories are effectively long-term earnings per share growth stories. And what we've found over many years of doing this, in fact, nearly 25 years of doing it, is that if you get the earnings growth roughly right over long periods of time, the price will follow.
So there's some huge numbers, as you mentioned, for PayPal, 20% growth. And is Spotify also double-digit growth?
Yeah, in fact, well, it's coming from a lower base. So actually, its growth is substantially larger than that. But I mean, a bit of that is baked into the price. But the good news is that the last month has seen quite a big reversal. So these companies' share prices have actually come back to where they were much earlier this year. And in fact, in one of their cases, back to November last year. So that's still accounting for the fact that both of them more than doubled in share price last year as a result of people using more digital payments, but also people listening to more music. And they were stuck at home, and they've switched from the radio to the choice of music. So instead of just listening to whatever radio plays, you can now choose the music you want. And we, you know, simply with tens of millions, 70 million plus tracks, there's just so much to listen to.
Absolutely. And I've got to admit, I'm users of both Spotify and PayPal, so you've got me right there. Target customer right here.
You are indeed a target customer. That's true.
You're talking to her. So we did you did mention recently what's happened in markets. It's been a bit of a pullback. But before we go there, I've seen some overarching factors between these two stocks. Did you want to go a bit around the framework as well? You've touched on the long-term growth trajectory, but let's touch on the framework as well.
Look, the businesses that we buy are businesses with great products where they're reinvesting a lot in the quality of the product. They are a market leader, and we can see a very large addressable market. So the opportunity for sales growth and therefore earnings growth, which is what investors should be interested in, and the ability of that earnings growth to compound over long periods of time, which is how you really make money, those are the factors that we're looking for. They're all large earnings growth, large addressable markets, and a lot of reinvestment in the product. Because what we want to be sure about over long periods of time is that this product will stay the leading quality product and that people will continue to buy it. And the good news is a lot of these businesses we own in our global fund are businesses that you can test from your own desktop or, you know, from your own wallet, as it turns out with PayPal. PayPal's a little harder. Some of their products aren't available here in Australia yet, but they will be in due course.
Fantastic. So we did touch on global markets recently, and there's been a bit of turbulence with expected inflation growth around the world. Now, what's your outlook for this, and how are you accounting for this in your portfolio?
Yeah, so our view, I mean, we take a 10-year view. That's the first thing about Hyperion. We're different from most. We're not trying to play the next month, 6 months, or even the next year. We think the next 10 years is a pretty low growth environment. That is low economic growth, low inflation, low interest rates. And look, there will be moments where things pop up. And now we're in a bit of a cyclical recovery after a disaster of last year. But most markets are just getting back to where they were in January, February last year, give or take a bit. So it isn't the major recovery yet. And we think that interest rates sort of lifting a little bit at the moment is just one of those short-term cyclical opportunities that actually give you the opportunity to buy in cheaply. Like, we don't get many of these come along, and I think it's one of them now. I mean, clearly we had one in mid-GFC, and we had one in March last year where we had 15% cash coming into March last year, and we invested in businesses like Spotify and Square and more in Tesla at that time of the year because we just saw the opportunity. Well, I think it's the same now. Is we've seen a pullback, that great opportunity. Long-term inflation, long-term interest rates low. There are more headwinds that will stop those things rising than tailwinds. The biggest driver of economic growth is population growth, and we don't have it.
We just don't have it anymore.
Indeed, and look, even if there's a baby boom tomorrow, population growth in Western economies is not going to have the carry-on effect in terms of economic growth for another 20 to 25 years. So you can be pretty certain that the next 20 years looks very flat. And that's why you need to invest in businesses that can actually produce 20% plus earnings per share growth, because that's how you'll make your money. Everything else is going to be very low returns.
Absolutely. And it's a winning formula, as we can see through your returns. So, Tim, thanks for joining us today on this webinar, and all the best with the upcoming launch.
Indeed. 22nd of March, we'll be looking forward to having lots of new investors. I'll be welcoming you.
Excellent. So Hyperion are launching their quoted fund, their global growth fund, under ticker HYGG, as we just mentioned, on March 22 to the ASX. So to learn more, please go to the ASX website or head to the Hyperion website and download their PDS. Thank you.